Hello and welcome to today's English lesson. My name is Stuart. In today's lesson, we're looking at idioms that use the word heart. Let's go to the intro. Now, as I said, today's lesson is looking at idioms with this word here, heart. Idiomatic expressions with heart. Of course, your heart is this part of the body here, the thing that makes your body function, that fundamental organ that we all have called the heart. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 idiomatic expressions with this word. And we're going to have a look through context if we can see and understand the meaning. So we've got the idiom, we've got a sentence, and we'll see through context if we can understand what the meaning of these idioms is, because idioms are difficult to learn, okay? So we're going to have to see if we can find the meaning through the context. Now, the first one is be or heart, be or heart. And we'll have a look at the example sentence. So somebody says, because you're sick, I've made some soup. And the other person replies, thanks so much, you're all heart. You are all heart, okay? So to be all heart. What does it mean to be all heart? Let's have a look through context. So we get the idea here that we mean to be generous, to be kind, okay? Thanks so much, you are very kind. You're all heart, very kind. You're generous, thank you very much. Now there's a different way we can use this as well in a type of sarcastic or ironic way. So for example, you can sort of use this in the opposite sense, being sarcastic or ironic. Sorry, I didn't make you any soup. Oh, thanks, you're all heart. Okay, so the opposite type of meaning that we can use as well. Now the second one here is to have a heart. Again, through context. Come on, boss, have a heart and let Fred finish early, okay? Come on, boss, have a heart, let Fred finish early. So to have a heart, what does it mean to have a heart? Let's have a look. So through the context here, we're encouraging our boss to be kinder towards Fred. Okay, to be kinder, to show him some sympathy and let him finish early because maybe he's been working a lot this week. Maybe he's worked a lot. So we need our boss to have a heart, to show some kindness towards Fred and let him finish early because he's had a busy week. He's tired. He's run down. Okay, so we want our boss to have a heart, to be kinder towards Fred. Now, the third one, your heart isn't in it. What does it mean? Your heart isn't in something. So, I tried to like my job, but my heart wasn't in it. My heart wasn't in it. What does it mean? Well, through context, we can understand that perhaps you were not interested in your job. You weren't enthusiastic towards your job. You couldn't get your heart into it. So, but my heart wasn't into the job. I wasn't interested in the job. I wasn't enthusiastic about that job. So I left. My heart wasn't in it. Next one, to not have the heart to do something. Now we saw this one is have a heart. This one is to not have the heart. Let's have a look through context. I just don't have the heart to tell the kids we can't go on holiday this year. I don't have the heart to tell them. What does it mean? Well, through context, we can see that it means that we don't want to hurt their feelings. We don't want the children to be upset. We don't want them to feel sad. I don't have the heart. I don't want them to feel sad because we can't go on holiday this year. So I don't have the heart to tell them, all right? So that's that one here. Now the next one is to take something to heart, to take something to heart. Jenny's quite upset. She has really taken your comments to heart. What does it mean if you take something to heart, especially comments or criticism? Well, through context here, Jenny's very upset. She's taken your comments to heart. It means that she has taken your comments too seriously. She's taken them to heart. She's been offended or upset by your comments. She's taken those comments to heart. So she's quite upset. She's really taken your comments to heart. Okay, she's taken them very seriously. Now the next one, to your heart's content. Again, look at the sentence through context. There's no school next week, so you can play to your heart's content. To your heart's content. Meaning that you can play all you want. You can play as much as you like because there's no school next week. So you can play to your heart's content. Okay? You can play as much as you want. Kids, play to your heart is content. Okay? So that is number six. And the last one, by heart. Now this one is fairly common. I suppose that you know this one already at this level, by heart. You have to learn these expressions by heart. What does it mean? Well, through context we can see that to learn something by heart means that you have to memorize it, okay? You have to learn it by heart. You have to learn it by heart, memorize. So you need to memorize these expressions. So to learn these expressions, you need to do it by heart. You need to memorize these expressions. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 expressions or idiomatic expressions with the word heart. Now, thanks for watching the lesson. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section below. Remember to share the lesson, please, on your favorite form of social media. Give the video a thumbs up as well if you liked it. I'll see you in the next English video lesson. Have a good day. Bye.